Yes, I have a loud voice. My name is Tom McPherson. I am chief instructor of Puristic Fighting and Martial Arts. Crikey, you've all gone quiet. We have been established for the last 5 years. We teach primarily Bartitsu, but several forms of Victorian pugilism, lasso art, and various forms of stick fighting. We have come here today to give you a humble demonstration of this, and hopefully no one will get hurt. Firstly, a note on safety. Because we only have one barrier, I would kindly ask that nobody comes anywhere near these. These are very heavy sticks, and I would hate for anyone to get hurt, as would my insurers. So please don't come through the barrier. So, back in 1902, Edward William Barton Wright decided to become an entrepreneur of Victorian martial arts. What he did is he went over to Japan and spent 3 years there learning jiu-jitsu. When he returned to London, he formed the School for Manly Arts, or the Bartitsu School of London, depending on your preference. With him, he brought several martial arts instructors back with him, namely Yukio Tani. Now, Yukio Tani was a very small Japanese man, about 5 foot tall, but he was no less very effective in what he did. He taught Barton Wright how to fight in jiu-jitsu, but knowing Victorian wasn't able to walk through Hyde Park with cane, he then adapted it so the average husband in morning coat could use their cane and have their leg on their side. Now Barton Wright, being a cunning man, adapted the cane. So he developed 5 strikes along with his jiu-jitsu. Now, as we only have a short time, I can't show you the 300 plus jiu-jitsu techniques he taught. What I can do is we can start now. Barton Wright form is stick fighting. Sarah, if you'd like to look at Barton Wright's own guard. Now, William Barton Wright, being a gentleman, wanted to make sure that people could wear their finery, such as yourselves, and still be effective in their art. So we'd have a nice wide stance. The cane would be raised in a defensive posture. If you know you're a gentleman, or a lady in this case, the hand would be open. So if someone tried to push you or approach you, you could push them away. As you'll see soon, I'm going to introduce you a different style of cane fighting made by an American. And they're slightly less gentlemanly, as you'll see. Now, Barton Wright form 5 principal attacks with the cane. 2 attack to the lower side, 2 attack to the upper side, and 1 attack to the head. So, come on. Bring the stick down and hope to strike the leg as you turn back to guard. Come 2. Bring it down and come to the side. And then return to guard. Come 3. Bring your attempting to strike the opponent squarely in the face. Cut 4, which comes round to the other side again, trying to strike the head. And cut 5, which... How many of you have seen Bram Stoker's Dracula? A few. The scene where Renfield offers a canapé to his keeper. Very much like Barton's Wright's cut 5. And comes down, and he presents the cane to them. Very gentle way, whilst at the same time cracking the top of the skull. So, we have several methods of defending against attack. So we're going to have our 2 students here come forward. This is Future and Santa of my students. There are occasions in bars like this where somebody would be in their coats and might get a little rusty, or a little rough, and they're required to lead. Take them by the hand and gently escort them to the door. In Barton Wright's first book, one of his first defences, is how to effectively escort the man from the bridge. Colloquially known as the gentleman's lead away. In fact, we'll make our dear Fusion Ruffian, because she's so much more dangerous than anyone else I've ever met. Which our ruffian attempt to attack her. Until they feel pain and they are forced to go wherever they lead. Again, once more. Cunningham, in 1912, created a book called Pain as a Weapon. Now Cunningham, unlike Barton Wright, was not a gentleman. He was a naval soldier, and he discovered that when his sailors were going on the shore, they were fighting with cutlasses, and people were dying. So what he said to them was, go on shore with this. Therefore, when you strike someone with it, you hopefully won't kill them. However, they didn't do an awful lot to dissuade you. Yes. The strike to the skull with this is just as effective as the strike to the skull. However, because Cunningham was teaching soldiers, and not the intelligentsia, not the ladies and gentlemen we see here, but the grunts, he kept it very simple. So Cunningham, in his very American way, said to his soldiers, I'll create two guards, a defensive guard, in which you will draw the hand up and have your hands and fist up at the solar plexus, ready to strike from the air. And offensive guard. Now, you must pay attention with the offensive guard. The offensive guard is a lot more complicated than the defensive guard. So the offensive guard. He's teaching soldiers to go defensive, offensive. Also, as a thought on an American point of view, Barton Wright has 5 cuts. Cunningham has 36. Barton Wright has 5 parries. Cunningham has 2. Left parry and a right parry. I kid you not, I nearly swore, and I kid you not, almost. In his treatise, The Cane as a Weapon, in 1912, he described that each parry should simply be a counterattack. So therefore, if I attack, that is simply not going to smack me in the jaw with a stick. Cunningham also had a different impression with regard to doing cuts. In the bottom right, will always have a very gentleman way of doing these things. Down and back to guard. Cunningham wants you to be swinging it as hard and as fast as you can. So, on the first cut, at this point here where you're striking the target, you want your maximum speed and strength. Simple physics then dictates you should only need to hit him once. So, cut one. Difference between that and Barton Wright's cut one is clear to see. He has no intention of being calm or polite. He has no intention of getting into gentle fights. He simply wants to hit someone around the head as hard as he can and walk away from the fight. Barton Wright.
Another defence from the rear. So,
you have to pardon my voice.
So you're walking through Hyde Park. It's a lovely Sunday.
They're like, they're darling, aren't you?
And the flowers beautiful.
Trees are rustling, birds are singing, it's all over.
And suddenly out of the bushes, some horrible person,
this time sat,
and grabs you manly from behind. Now, Barton Wright and Cunningham had different ways of dealing with this. Because Barton Wright was a gentleman, he wanted to be as polite as he could about it. Now, in his treatise, he says that when you turn, you take this point, you try and go for a nerve pinch at the elbow. It's a lovely thought, it's entirely incredible. As I'm sure you can all tell because you're wearing linen shirts, overcoats, coats and all that. Chances of you grabbing something here is not enough. And so instead, you strike the elbow as hard as you possibly can. This will jar the joint and release the grip. There, Barton Wright recommends you step forward and around and the arm behind the opponent. Again, because he's a gentleman, he doesn't really want to hurt anyone. Cunningham, however, is a little bit more aggressive about this. I have to take a moment because Sarah will require to wear a fencing mask for this. We do practice using modern safety equipment, otherwise there'll be a lot more injuries. So, Cunningham, with his infinite wisdom, not wanting people to get involved in a long fight, given the same scenario in his book. Your attack from here. Now, rather than mincing around, going for locks and trying to smash him, it's easy to say, take the cane in both hands and try straight up into the ribs. And then turn and strike him straight to the face. I don't want to mess around. You break the ribs, you break the nose, and you escape the fight. This shows a difference between Barton Wright being a kind gentleman and Cunningham being a very obvious soldier. Now then, at this point, I would like a few volunteers. What? Any more? What? I know you feel brave.
You promise you won't get hit in the head.
Looking forward.
No one else? Just the one? Excellent. Your name, sir?
Ross.
Ross, please be Ross. Everybody give Ross a round of applause. You have a victim, volunteer. Cara, please be your car. Round of applause for Cara, please. So, you both watched Barton Wright stance in which he raises his hand. What I would like you to do. Show you what to do. Raise your hand above your head like that. Now when Barton Wright formed school from under arts, he would train his students to hold these sticks in guard for upwards of 10 minutes. So you've got time to go and get yourself a drink while we wait for them to collapse. It's a bit like tea dueling, but with stick fighting, isn't it? The prime. I teach them how to swing a stick. Okay, so turn, face the crowd. What? Right. What I would like you to do is step to your double width. Bend your knees gently. Raise the stick and place your offhand over your chest. from here, the hand turns up.
Once more, turns up. To see what they had. However, George Buat says in this situation, you should defend vigorously as you possibly could. Now I'll have them do this twice because there's a lot in this. So firstly you will stomp to the foot, then hammer fist to the groin, turn around and grab them by the neck, hit them in the guts, and then hit them in the spine. All for just grabbing you from behind. One small skill. So, you send them drops, and... No! Yeah! This is why I don't mess with any of my female students, they're far too dangerous.
Local to us, we'd be very, very happy to have you.
and then we can throw you around and throw sticks at you. But for now, I'd like you to give thanks to Sarah, to Fuchsia, to Sam, and I have been Tanya humbled them. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we have a nice round of applause, please, for the Human Skin Fighters? They have come all the way from the deep cut of I do hope that you've all learned something today. Do not mess with ladies, they will hit you with a stick somewhere painful. And if you wish to learn more, we can always save you links and things to their wonderful website. Please get in touch.